one of my biggest focuses in all of the players that I train, from 09s all the way to college players, from the kids that I've had from 2015 all the way till now, is getting rid of their bad habits. Trying to get rid of their bad habits as much as possible, especially the young ones. I would say that a lot of the players that I've had since 2015, 2016, a lot of them have gotten rid, the consistent ones, a lot of them have gotten rid of their really, really bad habits. And this is how I look at bad habits. If you can get away with a bad habit now, you're probably not at the highest of levels. That if you're a U12 girl and you're able to receive with the outside of your foot and not across your body, you can get away with that at U12. But guess what? At U16, you're not going to be able to get away with that. Now, I get new U16 players into me, and they start receiving with the outside of their foot and pushing the ball back to where it came from and not receiving across their body, and they're all on B teams. And it's like, I wonder why you're on a B team and not on an A team, because that bad habit has never been fixed, because that bad habit, that won't fly at the highest level. You want to play college soccer, you better get rid of your bad habits as early as possible, because you can get away with it now because of the low level that you play at. But when you aspire to play at a higher level, you're not going to be able to handle that. You're not going to be able to get away with that, because at the highest levels, every mistake, every bad habit is punishable by a goal. And the more bad habits and the more mistakes you make, the less you're going to play, period. And I don't care who you are or what your pecking order is on the team. The more mistakes, the more times you lose the ball, you're going to be off the field and you're not going to play that much. So get rid of your bad habits now.